Marcus a chance to land a few cheap body shots.
Oh, yeah, this is his fight right here.
And help create the mentality of a brawl. Quick left hand by Mayweather as Marcus was lunging in.
Good round, good round.
Let's give him some water.
Okay, Goyo, es mejor que la soga.
Goyo, you're better at the ropes, so get him up against the ropes and punch him. You gotta throw punches on top, step back, and then hit him.
Y que contraataca.
Okay.
I'll wrestle him.
Small enough. Bien, deep in our throat. Okay, bro.
Mayweather has found his best shots with his right hand. Question here is whether he's willing to invest to break down Vargas, or he's going to be content to go the distance with an easy win.
Round five begins. Harold, how did you score the first four?
G9's a no-brainer. 4-0, 40-36, Floyd Mayweather Jr. Jim, I don't care. I think this kid's terrific. He's hitting with everything but the stool. I mean, if he ain't breaking him down, the referee must be hitting Goyo Vargas, because Floyd's whacking him with lead rights, doing whatever he has to do, controlling the ring, hitting him with terrific left hooks. Goyo Vargas can't catch him. It's
terrific left hook.
Terrific left hook, Jim.
Terrific left hook.
Terrific left hook. This is a good fight for Floyd.
All right. Thank you, Harold.
I'm glad somebody is enjoying this.
Right hand over the top. Left hand from underneath.
Well, when you're young and you've got the speed and the reflexes of a cheetah, you can get away with stuff.
That was a Prince Nassim punch.
Like throwing an uppercut from 8 feet away.
It's the biggest difference is just speed. It's just too much speed on Mayweather's part. But it's a good fight.
Slip a room. Richard Steele properly ruling that a slip. And still the moisture is there, incidentally, in the same spot on the paint. But this time Floyd skips over it. See Vargas hammering to the body whenever he gets a chance. Hoping to take some of Floyd's legs away.
Well, Mayweather is standing flat-footed. Maybe he thinks that Vargas is tiring a little bit.
This is why I would like to see him fight more.
Because?
Even though he's close, I think his hand speed is too much. And he would catch him with a punch much better than the punches that he's... When he shoots his right hand leads, there are punches that can land and get points, but they're not having that much problem. And I thought if he would fight at a closer range right here, he would eventually land and would catch him with a power punch. Otherwise, I think the fight's going to end up going to a 12-round decision.
There may be a small trickle of blood from one of Floyd Mayweather's nostrils. Either that or he's picked up blood on his face from Vargas' cut. Mayweather mixing in a left hand to the body in that four-punch flurry as he came out of the corner. I think Floyd's bleeding from the right nostril.
He's bleeding from the nose. Probably in the toughest professional fight that he's had in his career.
Not so tough that he isn't smiling in there from time to time about the way things are going, but...
Well, he's got control, and actually it's given him a chance to spend more of his time.
Has landed more power shots than Mayweather. Power shots meaning anything other than a jab. Hooks, crosses, uppercuts, and body shots all qualify in the CompuBox language as power shots. Vargas landing 13 to Mayweather's 10 in the fifth. Nevertheless, Floyd continues to control the fight with his speed and his footwork. Emmanuel Stewart, you've been quoted as saying that you train Prince Nassim with an eye down the road toward a possible huge showdown fight with Floyd Mayweather. You see Floyd switching south here as he might do against Maz's southpaw stance, what would your Prince Nassim game plan be against Floyd?
Well, I don't think he would switch with Nassim because Nassim is too dangerous of a puncher. He can take risks with this fighter because the guy's slow and he can get away with things. And actually, Floyd's seemingly enjoying himself at the fight now because it's turned out to be a good fight in terms of the crowd appeal, but he knows that he still has too much speed for Vargas, so he's seemingly enjoying himself now.
Would Maz just try to walk him down?
Well, Nassim Ahmed himself has good hand speed, but more devastating single punching power. Maybe Floyd has more speed all together in combination, but not as much power. It'd be a very interesting fight. And as Maz is learning to shorten up his punches more at this stage and keep his balance, it means that if they ever fight, maybe down the road in a year or two, it'll be a very exciting fight. It'll be a lot of speed and a lot of power.
Vargas still trying to get to Floyd Mayweather Jr.'s body midway through the sixth round. Floyd's had a couple of good flurries here in the sixth. And a good left hook to the body there.
None of his punches seem to be hurting Vargas, so he's landing a lot of punches, but from the expression I can get on Vargas' face, he knows that he's possibly losing on points, but he's not being physical here. And I believe as the fight goes on, he's going to start fighting a little bit more because his confidence is going to get up to the point where he believes he can't be hurt that much.
Tell me, Jim, is Vargas the first fighter we've seen with a website on his trunks?
He's the first Mexican fighter we've seen with a website on his trunks. How's that?
All right. Well, maybe he'll get knocked on his website tonight, but Mayweather is going to have to commit some passion to try to make it happen.
Vargas trying to give Mayweather a little straight right-hand lead action of his own. Manages to corner Mayweather for the moment. And wails away to the body. Just left hand from the shot by Mayweather.
Body shot that he didn't see.
6, 7, 8.
Well, he went down on his website.
When you finally go to the body, you often get results you're not expecting.
Well, I think the punch exploded. He never saw the punch coming, so it was effective. But going in this round here, I don't think it's going to have any.
You're okay.
Into the next round, I don't think the body punch is going to have any lasting effect.
The same way, you got to put him the same way.
Easy enough for you to say, Emilio.
You want to win?
Presión.
As it was winding down, they were in this scuffle on the right, on the ropes, and there's the punch right there in the solar plexus. As I noted before, when Vargas has Mayweather on the ropes, he's got Mayweather where Mayweather wants him because he's got him at close quarters and he can hit him with punches he may not see.
That's because Mayweather has much faster hands and better coordination in close.
Right hand lands for Mayweather. Vargas kind of grinning at him. And Emmanuel Stewart pointed out in the last round, Mayweather not really hurting him with head punches. But when he fired that left hook to the body and got a perfect placement on it, it was enough to score the knockdown.
The head punches, he's prepared for the most effective head punch that he's landed, basically the jab. Because Vargas is leaning in forward now as he picks the punches off so he can be in a better position when he executes himself. The early part of the fight, he was standing back blocking the punches, but he's trying to lean in more his head and his hands will be closer to Mayweather after he finishes up.
Well, in recent weeks, we've gotten some great illustrations of the importance of body punching. Prince Nassim loosening Gliani Bungu up with early body punches last week. Oscar De La Hoya knocking out Daryl Coley with a body punch. Felix Trinidad stopping David Reed's movement and ultimately breaking him down with vicious punishment to the body. The more young fighters learn to do it, the better they get.
I feel we've seen more of that since Roy Jones
knocked out Virgil Hill.
Knocked out Virgil Hill with that crushing shot.
a couple years ago.
Midway through round seven, Floyd Mayweather Jr. thoroughly in control, but Goyo Vargas able to show his vast experience and professionalism by eking out ways here and there to stay in the fight. Floyd busting through the guard with his right hand lead.
Those punches are very flashy, but they're not as effective as the shorter punches are, because Vargas can see the punches coming. When you see a punch coming, your muscles and your nervous system prepares to handle it. It looks good, but it's the punch that's a short.